out to my channel. Is this your first time of coming to my channel? Thanks a lot. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe. So in today's tutorial, we are going to make a simple video on how to achieve your elegant bonny design. Now, I am making use of this satin fabric, and note that you can use fabrics such as bridal satin, doll face, scuba, fabrics that are actually thick and like have structure. Okay, now we are making use of this bonny. Now this bonny is a sewable form of bonny, right? Look, this is what the sewable form of bonny looks like, and this means that I'm going to be stitching on the bonny because we want to achieve a sewable bonny. So we also have like the plastic bonny, which is not sewable. So, but I'm making use of this sewable bonny for this tutorial. You can use any bonny of your choice. Now, the length we need now is, for the first layer, the length we need for the first layer is 9 inches. But we are going to go ahead and add 2 inches to our allowance. We have 11 inches. Now, for the length this way, I'm going to go ahead and mark 11 inches. For my length, I'm going to mark 11 inches. Now, you also discovered that my fabric is folded into 4. I have folded into 2 this way and another one which is folded into 2. Now, the reason why I folded the fabric into 2 is because one fabric is going to serve as the main fabric and the other fabric will serve as the lining. So basically, I'm using the exact fabric to line the main fabric, and it makes it more cute and gives it like a very neat effect. So we've gone ahead now to mark 11 inches for the length. You can increase yours to 12 inches, 13. It depends on how long you want it to be, and you can also reduce it just in case if you want like a very small design. Now for what we need now, for the wideness of it, we are going to be making use of 7 inches for the wideness of it. But because we are going to be attaching our bonny to it, we are also going to add our bonny allowance to the length. So I'm going to make use of 8.5 inches for the wideness this way. I'll go ahead now and mark 8.5. So this is basically what we have. So I'll go ahead now and cut this out. This is what we have. So by the time you open this up, this is basically what you are going to have for the first layer. So we'll go ahead now and set this aside and then cut out the second layer of the fabric to place on it. Now we also have the first layer also and the second layer, which one layer will serve as the main fabric while the other one will serve as the lining. Now you should also note that the second layer is usually smaller than the first layer. However, the number of inches you deduct totally depends on you. So for the first layer, we have 11 inches for the wideness. You can decide that you want to make use of 7 inches, you can decide you want to make use of 8, 9, but note that the second layer is usually smaller than the first layer. So I'm going to go ahead now and make use of 7 inches for the length of the second layer. Okay, so let me add my sewing allowance to it, and I'm going to have 8 inches for the wideness this way. So I'm going to have 8 inches for the wideness. But note that for the length of what you need, you have to use the same for both the first. So note that what you need also for the width, you have to use the same measurements for both the first layer and the second layer. So the first layer, the width we made use of 8.5 inches. So for the second layer also, you will also make use of 8.5 inches. So you are only going to reduce the measurement of the second layer only by the length and not by the width. So we have 8.5 inches by 8 for the second layer, and the first layer we have 11 inches by 8.5 inches. So I'll basically go ahead now and cut this out. What we have, and of course we have the 2 pieces also. So we'll go ahead now and place the second layer on the first layer and see what we are going to have. So basically you can see that, you can see where our second layer ends and you can see the first layer. So you can also go ahead and make yours 3 layers. That means that you are going to make it like very little smaller than the second layer, right? So you can have 2 layers 3 4 5. It depends on the design and what you want to achieve. So this is basically what we have now. Another thing we have to do now is that you can decide that you want the tip of your layers to be this way, right? You can decide that you want it to be this way, and you can also decide that you want to give it a shape. It depends on you. But if you leave it this way, it means that you are going to have pleating at the end of the day, and this is what it's going to look like. So with this now, you will also discover that you can see that the shape is coming out, but you are going to have pleating this way. If you want to achieve yours to have pleating, then you go ahead and you leave it straight, right? But if you don't want it to have pleating or any fold, you have to go ahead now and reduce what you have at this part. So let me know what you guys feel, or which one do you prefer. Should we reduce it or should we leave it? It depends on what you want to achieve, but let me go ahead and reduce it just in case if you want to reduce yours, okay? So this is the first layer also, and I have the second layer, which is the lining, and I'm going to be doing it at the same time so that we have like the same shape for both the main fabric and the lining. So I basically just fold this like this just to give it some shape, and then I will just shape this out a little. So I'm basically just, this is what I'm basically just doing, just to reduce this tip. So I've gone ahead now just to mark that. And from this tip now, I just took off about 1.5 inches to shape it at that part. So we'll basically go ahead now and cut this out. Now to cut this out, this is what we have. Just in case, if you want here to be really small, you can still go ahead and shape this up to what you want, okay? At this point now, it depends on what you want to achieve and your creativity. And don't forget that when you are sewing, you like, creativity is what differentiates or bring out like another beauty, right? So this is what we have. I think it's okay this way. Now I'm also going to go ahead now and do the same for the second layer. I'll place it together now. For the second layer, I'll place it together, place my tape measure at this part, and then mark 1.5 inches. Mark 1.5 inches, and then I will just connect it this way just to shape this second layer. So if you shaped the first layer, you have to shape your second layer. But if you did not shape the first layer, then there is no need to shape the second layer. So whatever you do to the first layer, you are also going to do the same for the second layer. That's it basically. So yeah, this is what we have. I think it's okay. So by the time we go ahead now and place it on each other, you can see what it basically looks like. Now the next thing we are going to do now is to go ahead and add our stay to this. So now we want to add our stay. Now this is paper stay. What I have here is paper stay, and this is like the soft form of stay. So you can use this also, and you can also use your gum stay, right? So your gum stay makes it more stronger and firm, while your paper stay just give it like a little structure. So it basically depends on what you want. So you can either make use of your paper stay just to give it like a little structure, or you make use of your gum stay to make it like very strong, right? It depends on what you want to achieve. And also, you also need to consider the kind of fabric you are working with. So if you are working with scuba fabric, because scuba fabric is already thick enough, you can decide that you want to make use of your paper stay, or you can also use your gum stay if you want it to be really, really strong. It depends on what you want to achieve. But if you are going with your gum stay, what you use for the first layer is what you are going to use for the second layer. So if you are making use of your gum stay, you are using it for both your first layer and your second layer. If you are making use of your paper stay, you are using it for both your first layer and your second layer. So now, I will go ahead now and cut out my stay. So I'll go ahead now and cut out my stay, and then iron my stay to this, and I'll show you guys what it looks like. So guys, I've gone ahead now to iron my paper stay. So I made this of paper stay, and then I've gone ahead to iron it. I ironed it for like the two pieces. So for the lower block now, I ironed both the main parts and the lining so that I can have like a very strong structure. While for the upper piece also, I also ironed my paper stay also for the two pieces, and this is what it looks like. Okay, now the next thing we want to do now is to go ahead now and fix in our bonny. Now, because I said this bonny is the sewable form of bonny, it simply means that we are going to stitch this on the fabric. Okay, we are going to stitch this on the fabric, and because we are going to turn it with the other fabric which we serve as lining, we are going to turn it with the second piece of the lower layer which we serve as lining. So I'll basically go ahead now and place my bonny on this piece. Now I'll place it this way, and then I'll go ahead and stitch this. Okay, so you do that for the upper side and the lower side. So I'll go ahead now and stitch this. So now for the upper layer, we are putting the bonny on one piece, and for the lower layer now, I hope you guys understand, but feel free to drop your questions in the comment section. So for the other layer now, which is the lower layer, we are also going to go ahead and fix in our bonny, and I'll just go ahead now and do the same and stitch it on this side. Okay, so we are stitching it on the both sides of the lower layer on one piece, and also on both sides of the upper layer on one piece. And this is because for the second piece, this is our lining, okay, but we are making it of the same fabric to line the upper piece. So I'll go ahead now and stitch my bonny on it, and then I'll show you guys what it looks like. Please, if you have any question in the course of this tutorial, feel free to drop it in the comment section, and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe. So guys, we've gone ahead now to stitch our bonny on it, and you can see basically that because of the bonny is already popping up already. So what you are going to do now is to go ahead and place your back block on it, which is the lining, rather the piece which we are using for the lining, the second piece, and then you go ahead and turn this with your second piece. So this, now this is what we have. By the time you are done turning this with your bonny, you fixing your bonny on both sides, this is basically what it looks like. So you are going to go ahead now and give this a very nice press. Make sure that your iron is actually very hot so that this can actually lay well. It's supposed to lay well. So I'll go ahead now and iron this, and by the time you turn it to the back, you can see what it looks like, and that is what you also have for the upper piece. So I'll go ahead now and give this a nice press and show you guys what next you have to do. So guys, now we've also gone ahead now to iron this. You can see that by the time you iron it, it just lays well, and you've also ironed this lower piece. So you are basically going to place it on each other this way. Just place it on each other this way. Now for this part, now you can go ahead and weave it, okay? You can go ahead and weave it, or while you are placing it on your dress, I'll show you guys how to cover up that part. So this is what it basically looks like, you can see. So I'll go ahead now and put this on the mannequin and show you guys what it looks like. So guys, I'm going to show you guys how to achieve this on your dress. So we have these two layers now, the long layer and the short layer, which I explained in the course of this tutorial. So you go ahead now and place it this way. You can see how this is standing. So if you don't want yours to stand this way, you just have to go ahead and use like a lighter stay, which I'm going to explain in the course of this tutorial. So this is what it looks like. You can see what it basically looks like, and this just stands this way. Now for this part, you just have to go ahead and hem this part, or you stitch it backwards, you place it this way, and then you stitch it to come like this. So with this now, you are going to have like a neat edge at that part. This is what
it looks like. So you can see, you can attach it to this part, you can attach it to one side of your dress. I think it's more beautiful like this. What do you guys think? I think it's more beautiful like this. So you can just attach it to one side of your breast line or your bustier cut, and then it just falls this way to give you this. Another way in which you can also style this is you can use this as your sleeve. You can use this. Another way in which you can style this is to use this as your sleeve, especially for this longer piece. So all you have to do now is to attach it this way, and this will serve as your sleeve. You can see this will serve as your sleeve, and you can also take it up this way. So this will basically serve as your sleeve. By the time you attach it this way, side to side, this will serve as your sleeve. So this video, a thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe. Feel free to drop your questions in the comment section or any topic you want us to make a video on.